everyone, this is Ross. I hope you guys can hear me pretty well. I don't have my filming stuff with me today, but I do have my phone, so I'm filming it with the phone, and we're just sitting here waiting for the bus to come. We're gonna go to an onsen, which is a Japanese bath, public bath, and we just saw this farm really right next to the bus stop, right behind it, and there's all kinds of fruiting plants in here. All throughout Japan is some green space, and in any green space you find, I'm coming to the conclusion that they grow food in almost all the time. This is a pomegranate. I wish I knew the variety. It's quite old. Look at the trunk of this tree here. It's an old tree for sure, and it's loaded. The whole thing is just tons of pomegranates all over it. It's probably 15, almost 20 feet tall. We have strawberries down below on the understory here as a ground cover. We have peppers planted. Just unbelievable amount of things in here. I think that's a crepe myrtle. We have some eggplant that looks really, really nice. The stems on this eggplant are purple. You can see the eggplants are forming here. This looks like some kind of mint or something in that family, some kind of herb in that family, I'm sure. More eggplants. This is a beautiful, beautiful plant. Look at the eggplant there. We have some pine trees on the exterior of the thing here. The garden bed, I guess, or orchard. I don't even know whose place this is. There's random tomatoes. We have some, looks like cucumbers growing along the fence. The most common things, look, here's a head of broccoli. The most common things I've found here that people are growing is cucumbers and tomatoes. Here we have a kiwi vine. Just a very old, strong kiwi vine. And look at the amount of kiwis, guys. I really hope you guys can hear this and I can publish this. This is incredible, this little area here. I mean, it's such a small space, yet they're growing so much in here. And it's very beautiful. We have more kiwi vines just going across the entire place here, and back throughout here is more cucumbers. And believe it or not, we're in Japan and there's pawpaw. These are pawpaw trees. I've seen about three of them in this little space. And I don't know, this is more, maybe more ornamental here. This looks like some kind of stone fruit, maybe a cherry. It doesn't look like it's doing very well. You can see the trunk, it's quite old, perhaps a bit diseased. We need to probably do some kind of renewal process on this tree here to get any kind of crop, perhaps. It's too old. Look at this, what is this? This looks very interesting. Whatever this is, I wonder if this fruits puts out some kind of vegetable. I don't know. We also have all kinds of stuff growing in the rows. Konnichiwa. And all kinds of things. Pawpaw. I actually just got permission, guys, from the owner. She was telling me about a little bit about who does this. It's her father. And these are trees that her father received. Very, very small. And she allowed me to see the trees. That looks like a persimmon down there. We have just rows and rows of tomatoes. They look like for sauce. They look like aroma tote. I'm going to try to get to the other side of the property here. She's very nice. Everybody here is so nice that I didn't feel like I was intruding too much. We get to the other side of the property, and there's a nice fig tree there, maybe some more crepe myrtles here. And this looks like maybe a nectarine or a peach, but I don't see any on the tree, so I wonder if that's the case. But very, very beautiful property. You can see just the tomatoes and rows of different things. And yeah, I mean, this is just what they do here in Japan, I guess. So very beautiful. And here's a very large persimmon right here. It's putting out a lot of fruit, and I wonder what kind of persimmon this is. If it's the hard or soft, Fuyu or Hachiya. Very old tree. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this one. I certainly did, so I'll talk to you guys later. Take care.